Thank you so much, and thank you for the invitation. It is a pleasure for me to be here today with all of you. I believe that it's clear, and Peter has emphasized this, how OGP offers a unique opportunity for countries all over the world to come together with civil society organizations, governments, and other stakeholders in order to find common solutions to shared problems. And of course, that this includes having a good lobby regulation, if you want to put it like this. The first step is having commitments as part of national action plans. And the challenge, as usual, is implementing those commitments. And when it comes to implementation, I believe that's something that the COVID-19 crisis has shown to all of us, that is that while commitments are a first step, this is not enough. It has also shown us how collaboration and trust is key in time of crisis, and how unfortunately corruption at the same time is allowed to flourish. And just to give you a very clear example about this, at Transparency International, we did a scan of media articles on COVID-19 and corruption crisis, and we find that only in 19 media articles, $1.1 billion has been lost because of corruption. And this amount of money means not only the economic loss, but what is more important for us is the amount of people that were not able, for instance, to get their COVID test, mask, or essential things in order to overcome this crisis. That is why we believe that collaboration, again, is key. Trust in governments is now more than ever important. And that's why we welcome the commitments from governments in order to increase their lobby regulation. I want to emphasize again that commitments are only the first step. What we want to actually see is the implementation of those commitments. And when it comes to collaboration, it is clear for us that it's also time to strengthen this collaboration. As civil society organization and as the space shrinks around the world for all of us to do and perform our difficult task, we believe that NGOs have a critical role to play in this COVID-19 crisis. And of course, that you could say that I am bound to say this because after all, I work for an NGO. But as far as I see it, we civil society organizations bring a set of unique skills around the table. First of all, we hold governments accountable for their commitments. And sometimes some governments may not like this, but we do this because we actually want to see a change. And because in doing so, we strengthen the champions inside governments that also are willing to make this change happen. At the same time, we have technical expertise. And I believe that this conference is a clear example of this. I was so glad when I received the program and I saw so many colleagues from civil society that will be part of this discussion, sharing their technical knowledge on lobbying. And we also facilitate peer-to-peer learning and knowledge exchange. That's why, again, the OGP platform provides all the stakeholders, including civil society, a unique opportunity to come together in order to discuss these important challenges that we are all facing. It is really great to see so many stakeholders as part of this important conference. I'm sure the conversations are going to be very productive, and I'm looking forward to the outcome of the discussion. Thank you so much.